So it's commonplace now to have battery devices, phones, iPads, tablets, etc., and to be charging them up. And they've incorporated now USB socket outlets within our 13 amp BS1363 socket outlet, which is a fantastic idea. Unfortunately, the plug-in section for our charging units or charging unit leads, because the charging unit is actually built into the back of the device itself, is permanently fixed into the on position. So the switch itself has no correlation to the USB charging point below, meaning that it's permanently connected. Our problem is when we carry out our insulation resistance test, the electronic components built in here are part of the circuit, and the 500 volts that we use to test them at will damage those components. So how are we going to overcome doing our insulation resistance test, or what are we going to have to do in order to remove that part of the circuit on brand new installations or in periodic inspections in order that we can carry out an insulation resistance test? Fantastic solution to a problem that our charging unit's already built in. Problem to us as electricians is that our insulation resistance test will pick it up and damage that part of the circuit. So let's go back into the workshop and see what we can do. So I'm back in my electrical workshop, and we've now got our USB socket outlet, and I've connected up a cable into the back of it so we can perform the insulation resistance test to see what we're going to get with the permanently connected equipment being the USB socket at the bottom that isn't affected by these switches. These switches are only doing the 13 amp plug tops and not the USB point. So when we press for insulation resistance, they'll be permanently connected, as will the electronic components in the back. Manufacturers say that we cannot test that at 500 volts because we will destroy them, as does BS7671. So therefore, if we were to do a test to see if we could pick those up, we should be doing it at 250 volts. So let's see what 250 volts reading will get on insulation resistance when we're testing between live conductors. So between line and neutral, therefore those electronic components are in circuit. Let's see what that result's going to be. So we could be on a periodic inspection or unaware of the electrical equipment connected to a new install, and we may find that we're going to do our insulation resistance first of all at 250 volts to see if something has been left in, like a lamp, or in this case, the USB socket outlet, which is permanently connected. So when we're testing between live conductors, I press and hold my insulation resistance test button, we see we have a reading that eventually, when it settles down, is less than 1 megohm. We know the smallest acceptable value of insulation resistance for the whole installation is 1 megohm. However, we're testing at 250 volts. We've obviously picked something up in circuit. It could be that we've left a lamp in, but in this case, we've got a USB socket outlet connected across line and neutral and not a lamp. Therefore, we must disconnect it if we were to do an insulation resistance test at 500 volts. On a periodic inspection, it would be acceptable to link live conductors together, so line and neutral together, and test them only to earth, because we cannot remove all of these lamps, or in this case, USB socket outlets, with ease. On a brand new installation, we'd be expected to do the test across all conductors. Therefore, we would be expected to remove the electronic components in here and carry out the test. That requires us to go into the socket outlet and disconnect either the line conductor from the back of the socket outlet or the neutral conductor. And if it's on a ring final circuit or upstream on a radial, we'd need to join the two conductors together and leave them in the back of the box, replace the front, and do the insulation resistance test with the electronic components disconnected. So in other words, then we wouldn't pass it through the electronic components offered by the USB outlet, and only insulation resistance test the cable in that case. So we'll also see what we're going to do when we go into the installation to have a look at what that looks like as well. So I've got a very small radial circuit here that my students do after about 12 weeks with us at college, and somebody has inserted a USB socket outlet. At this stage, I wouldn't expect the learners to have realised that that electronic equipment was in when they're doing the insulation resistance test, but it's quite a good rig to prove a point. So if I was to test between line and neutral, which I will do at some point between live conductors for insulation resistance test, I'm obviously going to pick up the USB socket outlet, which is permanently connected. As we said before, these switches will not turn on and off the sockets for the USB. So insulation resistance should be done at 250 volts where we're unsure of equipment in circuit, and let's see if it picks it up again. So if I test between my neutral bar and the top of my breaker, turn my instrument to 250 volts. Carry out my insulation resistance test we can see once again we have picked up the electronic components permanently connected, and our reading is less than 1 megohm. What we have proved, however, in that circuit, there isn't a dead short, so we haven't got zero. So in other words, when the circuit was energized, it would obviously disconnect the overcurrent protection device, but there's something in circuit, and on a periodic inspection we've got to go out and have a look and find out what we've left in circuit. It could be we've left something plugged in, but in this case all the socket outlets have been removed of the items that were plugged in, but we have got a permanently connected USB socket outlet. For our initial learners coming in, finding equipment that's been connected on an initial verification of their own work, so the install, and they've got to test it, and we're going to have to do the insulation resistance test at 500 volts, similar to what we did with our lighting circuit, where we had a fluorescent lighting circuit's electronic components in. We had to disconnect either the switching line out of that or the neutral out of the actual fitting itself, removing the electronic components, allowing us to do the insulation resistance test. So we're going to have to take off the socket front. In this case, it's part of a radial circuit, there'll only be one connection in there. If it was a ring final circuit, there would be two. And we can either disconnect the neutral conductor and put it in a connector block at the back, or disconnect the line conductor and put it in the back. If it was a ring final circuit, we'd have to disconnect both neutrals or both lines and put them in a connector block. Replace the cover, so therefore we can do an insulation resistance test with the electronic components disconnected. So let's do that in the next stage. So I've dropped my socket outlet front off, or maybe I would have done it during the initial second fix. But I've actually disconnected, in this case, the neutral conductor. Wouldn't have mattered if I disconnected the line conductor. I've inserted into a connector block, and remember, if it was on a ring final circuit, that would be two neutral connections. And I'm going to leave them in the back of the socket outlet. I'm going to replace the cover and go to the install and do the full insulation resistance as we have done previously for lighting circuits. So that would remove the electronic components which feed the USB socket outlet. This section here is now disconnected. So we can pass 500 volts through the circuit and complete a correct insulation resistance test for our initial verification of our brand new circuit. So let's put the front back on and carry out the insulation resistance test with the socket outlet disconnected as such, or the electronic components are disconnected. So with the insulation resistance test up to our level two students, we're actually going to do all three. So we'll do between line and neutral, between neutral and earth, and line and earth, in no particular order. We're going to set it now to 500 volts, and we expect our insulation resistance for a brand new circuit to be in the hundreds or thousands of megohms, or off the scale in other words. We know the smallest acceptable insulation resistance for the whole installation has to be greater than 1 megohm. So we expect now, with the electronic components disconnected, a fantastically high reading for insulation resistance. So I clip onto the neutral bar, and I'm going to go between live conductors first. Press and hold. And now with the electronic components disconnected, we have a reading that's exceed the machine, so greater than 999 megohms. Move it across. Test between earth bar and the line connection. And once again, I've got a reading greater than 999 megohms. And finally, between neutral and protective conductor. And again, greater than 999 megohms. It's important now I go back into the installation and reconnect the socket outlet so the neutral goes back into the back of the socket. However, if I forget, I will pick it up on a live earth fault loop impedance test, or when I'm rechecking polarity, the socket outlet itself won't work. However, on a new install, I'd like to think that I'd remember to go back into the install, reconnect the neutral, before moving down the sequence of tests.